If you're looking to incorporate powerful AI tools into your business and workflow, this is the video to watch. I've had a chance to try many copywriting tools, AI avatar creation, email marketing, ad campaign management, video editing and optimization, logo creation, and so much more. In this video, I'm going to make a recommendation for some of my top tools. These are my favorites. Stay tuned. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome to my channel, where I promise practical advice to build your brand. Today is a roundup of all my favorite AI tools for small businesses. And trust me when I tell you that I have tried many. These are my favorites. Let's dive right in, starting with copywriting. For copywriting, let's start with some tools designed specifically to use AI to help you copywrite. Now, Jasper is a popular one. I really like this platform. Notice at the time of recording this video, there's a special trial offer. So you might want to check that out. You can actually use it for free. Really a lot of different uses that you might need for copy. So Jasper is a great one, linked below. Let's look at a few more. Anyword is a tool, full disclosure, that I've partnered with in the past. So I've created video content for them, and I'm definitely a fan of this tool. I know it very well because I used to work with them to create explainer videos. It's another tool, but it is paid. They do offer a free plan, but it is pretty limited. So if you're wanting to pay for a tool that's designed to help you write copy quickly, this might be one that you consider. Anyword. Let's keep going. Copy.ai is another variation of this. So this one's used to write blogs. We've been experimenting with it recently to use, you know, podcast episodes, write them as blog posts. Again, a platform like this has access, you know, API access, I don't know the specifics, but access to a tool like ChatGPT, which we're about to talk about. That's what everyone else is talking about. It has access, you know, to be able to, but just a cleaner interface to be able to help you write copy. That is the purpose. So those are three tools that are paid, but a lot of them offer free introductory plans so that you can check them out. Now, I can't make this video and not talk about ChatGPT, which, by the way, hit 1 million users in 5 days. That's got to be a record. With a quick search on YouTube here or on Google, you're gonna see all kinds of guides and resources and posts about how to use this effectively. I promise that I'm gonna talk more about this in the future. I'm still kind of in that research phase to figure out what I think of it. I'm excited about it, but I'm not like, oh my God, this has changed my life. Not yet, but I'm very interested about the direction that AI is going, and this is certainly leading the way. So I wanna show you an example prompt. That's how ChatGPT works. So here I put my YouTube title for this video, but it gave me exactly what I wanted, 20 variations on this title. Very cool. Again, more to come on my channel regarding ChatGPT. I love AI for copywriting. Did you know that you can also use it to create logos? Now, this is something I know you're gonna love. It is so simple. I'm a very proud Adobe Express ambassador, and one of my favorite tools that they offer is this logo maker. So let's actually type in an example here. My restaurant business, define the type of business. Let's give it a name. Yummy Noodles, that's a good example. Okay, let's say that's the name, and if we have a slogan, we can add that in here. Let's click next. That's the first question done. Second question, we choose a style. So bold, elegant, modern, decorative. Let's choose modern for this example. I like that style. I'll click next. Now we can choose an icon. So it's going to pre-populate some options here. And I'm loving some of these, but let's say we want noodles since that's the name. I love this one. It's flat and beautiful and minimalist, which is very much my style. We're getting closer. Adobe Express is using AI to populate some really beautiful starting points for logos. I guess I'm really drawn to this one. It's really beautiful. And again, we're going to click customize. And this is a starting point for our logo. Okay. So we can see how it looks in digital, in print, and on web. I'm loving this. If we want to download it, if we're happy with it as it is, we can make some minor adjustments here. Or if we want to customize it more, I like this option. It's going to bring exactly what we've created in answering three questions right over to Adobe Express, where you can then make any adjustments that you want. If you want to change the size of elements, if you want to change the font, Adobe Express has integrations with Adobe Fonts. In my opinion, the best font library on the internet. You can really go to town and have some fun. And using AI, it's helping you with a beautiful starting point here in Adobe Express to create an awesome logo. Simple. I love it. Now let's shift to a platform that uses AI, but still involves humans, which is important, especially for creating design assets. Lots of them and as many as you want. Using the same example business, Yummy Noodles, you're looking at two logo designs that were not designed by AI, they were designed by humans using a service that I love called Penji, an unlimited graphic design service that acts as a monthly subscription for all your design needs. That's right, it's unlimited. So I decided on the logo that I love here. This looks awesome. And because it's unlimited, I'm not just gonna design the logo, I'm also going to think about what else I might need. And in this case, I need a brand style guide, right? And so using this service, I can have, you know, an amazing designer somewhere in the world help me out with creating the guidelines so that anyone who touches my brand in the future knows what rules to follow. Again, Penji is not using AI to design the logo. It's using human graphic designers to design the logo, which is why it looks amazing. But it uses AI to decide which designer is best appropriate for your job based on their experience, their skill set, and their portfolio. Amazing. I love Penji, linked below. Penji is great. Now let's make an AI avatar together. Human me, AI me. There's one platform in the lead for this, and it is called Synthesia. You might be wondering how we generated that AI version of me you saw a second ago. This is footage of me making my custom Synthesia avatar. And I gotta tell you, this is a lot of fun. They give you very specific guidelines to follow so that the avatar that's generated looks amazing. My finished avatar looks like this. Now I've got this amazing avatar using AI. I absolutely love Synthesia. It's the leader in the platform. And of course, I'm gonna link to that in the description below. And I'll also link on screen to this video where I create the custom avatar in more detail if you're curious to watch that. Let's keep going. Video editing, even that can be made more efficient thanks to AI. Watch this. Maybe you've used a tool like Descript. This is a popular one. I haven't actually spent a ton of time in here, but I still wanted to mention it as a tool for video editing that incorporates AI. You can actually edit your video based on words. I use another tool for this. It is from Adobe. It's called Project Blink, and I absolutely love this AI-powered video editing on the web, and you can do a lot in here. From searching for objects and sounds, it'll actually pick up those things in the video. And then obviously, like I talked about a second ago with Descript, editing videos just like you edit text, so it'll literally transcribe it. You can click the section, I'll show you in a second, click the section that you want to delete and it's gone. So many other things you can do here, pull out key moments, great for Instagram Reels. You can remove what we would call verbal tics, like ums. I just did one a second ago, and you know, I say, well, you know, things like that. If I wanted to remove them, I could, because you can actually identify them. When I hop over to the tool itself, it looks a little bit like this, okay? So, and I'll put the link in the description below. At the time of recording this video, you may have to request access, but this project has been made public, so I'm allowed to talk about it, and it certainly is something you should be able to access. If not now, soon you will be able to. This little video will walk through how to use it. And when we actually log in here, it's very simple. You can upload your video here. Your uploaded videos will stay. If you want to give it a try, you can actually use a sample video. I'm going to go ahead and click on this video, which I just uploaded. So it'll preview it there and I can create a project. Let's go ahead and create that. It'll take a moment to load. And once it loads, have a look. It already transcribed the video. And if, for example, I wanted to delete a section, let's say I want to delete this sentence, boom, I delete it and that edit has actually already been made. This makes editing so easy. It'll also, one step further, it'll identify the speakers in the video. So it does this cool little thumbnail, which is my face from the video. So if you have, for example, a Zoom call or something where you've got more than one person, it will make it easy to identify who says what and then to be able to edit from there. Love this tool. Now, a few more. Here's an email marketing platform that incorporates AI and it's really awesome. Mailmodo, it's called, and it's really unique in the industry. I've really had a lot of fun with Mailmodo since discovering it. It uses AMP, which stands for Accelerated Mobile Pages, to add really fun interactive elements into your email, almost like you'd see in an app, but it's directly in an email without the user having to leave. Here you see a number of graphics. So right here is this amazing little survey feature feature that could be so useful in getting feedback from people. You don't have to send them to a separate page. You keep them directly into the email. Mailmodo definitely uses AI to combine data analysis, personalization, copywriting, all in one streamlined process so that you can just focus on creating something interactive and beautiful and easy for your user to digest. And this platform definitely accomplishes that. Now let's talk about multi-channel ad management. Ads that you're running on Google, Facebook, and Instagram, there's an AI tool for that. Check this out. I don't know about you, but I find running ads pretty intimidating, and Otis has taken all of that fear and hesitation away by allowing me to create campaigns and run them across multiple platforms like TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, Google. Here you see me setting up the creative, so I've already defined my audiences before this point. I've put what I thought is good starting copy, but it's actually using AI to make suggestions on copy that will perform even better by giving it a score. And here I am experimenting with something that is ideally going to score well so that it's going to position my ads to perform great. I love Otis because all you need to worry about is the creative, the images or videos that you want to use for your ads. Otis helps you figure out everything else and also track the performance of your campaigns and allocate the most budget to where the best ads are performing, which means that no stress for you. You really just focus on the creative and Otis does the rest. I'll also link, along with all the other tools mentioned in this video, to Otis in the description below. So there you go. A handful of really cool tools that incorporate AI that are perfect for various aspects of your small business. I've linked to all of the apps below. Go ahead and check them out for yourself. If you've got any lingering questions, comment below. Let's keep the conversation going on down there. I respond to those personally. And if you enjoyed this roundup video, give it a like. That helps other people discover these videos, which we work hard to create for you. And subscribe for more of my videos on branding, positioning, building, and promoting your brand. Next, I'm sharing a few videos I think you'll be interested in. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. Those are coming up next.